Welcome, my friends, to the demo of Airborne Empire. I got also early review key of the demo from the developer for this one too. You can see in the top left. So thank you so much for that. I appreciate that. If you want to check out Airborne Empire, go on Steam. The game is planned for early access in Q2 of 2024. And I think there will be a demo also available during the next festival. Airborne Empire is also a city builder with strategy and a bit of survival and things like that. It's quite unique. You will see when you play it. Yeah, I did not play it yet, but I watched the trailer. I was like, oh, that looks really quite unique. So take a look. We made it to the skies! It's hard to believe our small group might remake the flying cities of old, but every story has a beginning. If we recruit new followers and truly grow this into a flying city, maybe we'll stand a chance again to sky pirates. It feels like they really rule the airways right now. Anyway, enough daydreaming about reuniting an empire. Our first priority is to build ourselves a hangar that will let us gather resources from the ground below, so we can build housing and other buildings. Once we've got our bearings, let's visit Havenmill, that big city north of us. Surely they have news of recent happenings. Okay, town center. Build. Hangar. Contains aircraft used by workers to gather resources and interact with people in the world below. So we are on a spaceship. Also we are in the air, see? We're flying in the air and yeah, we built here. Ah, so wait, how do we, are we rotating? Oh, but is there not a path? Wait, overlaps existing constructions. Let me see how that works. I thought we have to align the blue arrow. Does not seem to be the case. But first thing, I'm already not making good. Doesn't seem to matter where I build. One front, two right. I'm not sure what to do. Okay, wait. Click the left mouse button to select objects in the game. Hold the right mouse button while moving. Blah blah. Use blah blah. You see to recenter your camera. Okay. Close. On the top bar, you can see amount of people that have joined you. On the left, number of people. On the right, the number of that can be housed. Each person requires a spot in a house. Okay, here's all housing. I tried that, Logan, but it does not work, as you saw. Ah, so maybe we have to make a path. Maybe like that. I thought we have to align the arrows, but it does not work. I mean, you can look again in case you did not see it. But you can go here, see, next to each other, and it will not work. But I guess they mean we have to make a path, like really path, like that. So, for example, like this. And then we maybe can build something there. I'm just guessing now. I don't know it. So I will just make now a path around the whole thing. So, and then in the future, we maybe can build. See? Maybe they should just set it. Build a street. Oh, build a street. So, I also thought we have to align the blue, just the blue arrow, correctly. Okay, so and then it depends where you build the tilt, the building with tilt. So maybe make it in the middle now. I guess when you build too much on one side, it will fall, you know, on one side and then turn around. I guess. Ah, here. Any buildings must be connected to the town center via path. These walkable platforms also act as sturdy connections between buildings. When placing buildings, pay careful attention to tilt, as adding too much weight on one side or other will tip your kingdom, which may annoy your population and slow you down. Annoying is not so bad. I thought they will die, yeah? They're really cute, no? The little ones here? Our people? They look really cute. Okay, movement. Unlike other kingdoms, your kingdom can move. Simply right-click anywhere on the land and you start moving in a direction. Being unmoored has its advantages. You can get closer to resources that would be otherwise be too far away. The closer you are to a resource, the faster we gather it. Can we, oh, we go maybe this way? Ah, so you're flying now around. Science can do tilting, we can try later, yes. We can try that. The heart of your flying kingdom stores as fuel for the large fan. If you ever deplete, our home will fall to the ground. Oh. You collect your wood? Construction of a flying platform is hard. Beyond basic and storage buildings, you must research any constructions at the academy so they may work in the skies. The people don't have many ideas for buildings yet, but an iron forge would be useful addition so that you can transform, I don't know, something to something. Create an academy and start researching an adobe kiln. Need first wood. But it's really pretty with the birds and everything, oh? How are we not collecting things? Ah, here, assign workers. 62 remaining, about 2 per trip. Assign workers to collect wood from this forest. Okay. Ah, yeah, so I said now 5. Oh, do they? They fly down. Look at them. Whee! Here. Whee! Oh, that's really unique. I did not expect that. And then they fly back. Oh yeah, so they're collecting my wood and come back. Hello Nimerul, how are you doing? Not connected to path. Yeah, I thought it, Logan, but I had a different idea what they mean with that. I thought the path is the blue arrow out from the building. I did not think that we had to make a, you know, extra street. So, but now we know that. They fly. I think they are birds. Look at them. They fly down and come back. They have wings. I can't zoom closer, I'm sorry. Nee. Hallo Max, how are you doing? But it's so cute, look at them. Oh, these are little planes. We wait that they're coming back. So now they're coming back. So look, this is the hangar. Let's see how they come back. Whee! Oh, the animation is really cute. Really well done. Whee! Whee! Okay. Now we have wood. So now we can make academy.
Steadfast supporter.
Did you nick it this in a good way so far? Like, yeah, also so far, it really, it's a nice idea that you fly around and that you have to build a city in the air. Academy complete. Now that we have built the academy, we can start to research new technology. Researching is how we can take ground technology and adapt it for use in the skies. Quantitech, thank you so much for gifting a sub to Max. Max Disrespect, enjoy the emotes. Welcome to our family. And Quantitech, thank you so much for your kindness. It's really kind of you. Thank you so much. You gifted in total so far 77 subs on this channel. Thank you. Thank you for your generosity. Okay, we're researching. I guess you have to move always around. I'm not sure if you... Maybe you can. Ah, we can also send here some workers. How many workers do we have? 3? Send some here. Here's a town. That's the tavern in the small settlement, huh? Seems like we may have caused a steer on a way in. Everyone in town is eyeballing us right now. So some of them seem mighty interested in our flying home. If you think we need more workers' hands, I bet we could convince a few of these folks to join. Right now we don't have enough housing to recruit anyone else. Recruits want their home before we will join. How do we make a house? Housing. Make here. Okay, we don't have houses anymore. Oh, maybe we can't go more far away. Workers are still gathering coal, but its storage is full. Oh. Iron Forge researched. We can now build Iron Forge. Housing block. Increase the size of housing, allowing it to shelter 8 people. Require 25% less food per worker. Oh, there's a big research tree, warehouse. Fan Propulsion Combat. Seems to be also combat is here. Maybe make a warehouse. Oh, here's a map. Okay. So, okay. So we need more wood. So we have enough. 5 buildings are of sufficient light. Workers may have accidents that lead to injuries. How do we make light? Can we make a lift? Okay, I don't know how you make light, yeah? But the world is beautiful, or I mean, look in the distance. Is it not nice? You have the birds going around, you have the ocean, cities, and everything. It's really a unique idea. I mean, that you gather everything from on top and you have to move on. I mean, they said the forest will, we did replant the forest and it will regrow over time. But there's also fishies, or we can collect fishies. Look at that. Wait, then we make maybe this one, this worker. We have enough food. Okay. We have gold. Sorry, guys. Okay. More people gathering resources, panel bullet hover. And swarm cost 20 wood. Okay, we need more wood. Yes, we said. Yes, I need this. Yeah, it's really nice so far. Getting worried. Oh, you don't need to have to be worried. Not getting sick. It's getting dark. Uh oh. Okay. So now we have enough wood and we can build an iron fort. Nearby forest has been fully chopped and replanted. Water. How can we collect water? I must to hunt for gold. Yeah. Iron forge cannot work because it's missing ore. Coal. Cotton. Forest. We need ore, coal, ancient ruin. Hi, Gisten. Hmm. Yeah. That's a really, really unique way of making a city builder. Really cool. I'm really impressed. It's really, really nice. And we just started to build, but I saw in the trailer, you really build like a huge platform later. And there are also space pirates which attack you. Then you have to build towers on your platform too, while flying around and managing everything. So it's pretty, pretty cool. Ancient ruin. Oh, it's far away. These fellows have a long way to settle here. Let some travel with us. Oh, we need more houses. Here. Wood production, basics, housing. Not enough lift to support weight. What? What do we need? Ah, we need a fan. And for the fan, we are missing iron, I think, or to wait for that then. Okay, have some more people. So, here. Okay. So, where was our iron? It's already empty. Oh, it's empty. So you have to go more to the left. We need more iron. Can't wait to the downfall of our empire to play out the anime Laputa Castle in the Sky. Is it really an anime, Iron? Oh, there's water. We're missing water. Infirm? Idle? With each building you construct, track is added to your kingdom, which slows down your movement speed. To get your speed back up, you must create propulsion buildings. You continue using resources like coal, food, and water. The faster you travel, the less time it takes to get places, and the fewer resources you will use along the way. Or build enough propulsion to get close to your max speed, or upgrade a town center. Put a castle in the sky. Really, really worth to watch. Okay, we'll check it out. Too far. Okay. Need one more iron so we can get the propulsion thing going on. Maybe we should upgrade in our town center. It's already empty. Iron. That was quick. Okay, but we have enough iron, so we can now build. Oh, we got that. Town center. Yeah, less water per worker. Increase lift provided by home base. Must be applied per building after researching. Connected to path. Okay, we need there a pathway. Oh. And then lift and also we have to wait that the path is built. Oh, we have a bit of tilting, or? Oh? 13 buildings of sufficient light. I'm not sure what we have to do for more light. But we are now faster, it's true. We are faster. Really, really worth to watch. Any Miyazaki movies worth to watch? I adore Totoro. I heard about Totoro, but I did not watch it either. Insufficient aircraft. Build more hangars. Ach. Okay. We need more of them, so they can have more people fly around. Good to know. Havenmill is the largest city in the Erie outside of the capital Litalos itself. It's really grown from the small farming village in once was. Should visit Magistrate Agatha in the tower. Well, you folks don't look much like pirates. Oh, don't worry, we are not. But that's a relief. Have to admit, it's been a long time since I've seen a machine like yours above the Erie that wasn't aiming cannon fire down to us. But I remember the old stories, the flying cities, the adventurers that piloted them from place to place across the world. Now we need of help. They're gonna act the part of I'm going to have to tell Pyle to get out of the vaults again. He hates it when I do that. Every time one of these pirates passes by us, I can't get back to sleep for hours. I always make such a record. See? Now listen, if you're really gonna fly that thing, you should help us out. The old airborne kingdom was a place of learning, of construction, of valiant deeds. You can start by helping us rebuild our academy and market. That last pirate attack really did a number on us. But what would you have us to do? Well, I can direct the building, but we need resources. Traveling by foot isn't safe anymore. But it doesn't look like much of a problem for you. We need wood and iron. Okay. Our workers are currently assisting in the repair of the city. We should wait for them to finish. Go to tavern. Hello, I'm the tavern keeper from Havenville. Wow, the area is very green. Miyazaki, you mean they're all Ghibli movies, oh? Okay. Oh. Yep. Okay. I just, with Miyazaki, I think more about other stuff. Like, Miyazaki is also Dark Souls, oh? Oh, that's true. Yes, Grand Attack. Like here, it's really pretty, right? When you look here around. And also the distance, you can see the two. That's true, yeah. Let's see, we can make. Oh, we need wood again. And we need more houses, another hangar. For hangar, we need wood. Oh. Damage to Havenville has been repaired. Speak to Magistrat in Havenville. Would you look at that? Your savior kid. With the academy and market back operational, Havenville is going to live to fight another day. But we it's really nice to make it. It's really, I really like that. But we would be a gracious neighbor if we didn't pay you back in kind. Here, take this blueprint. Make sure to light your buildings and pass at night. Can be dangerous in the dark. You need glass to build street lamps. That's a rare resource these days. We'll give you enough to get started, but you probably want to make your own eventually. Thank you. Oh, you're so polite. I told Pyle to do the real thing. Give the blueprint to a scholar at your academy. They will know what to do with it. You're ruler of the city now. You have to start acting like it. Now I do have more things to ask you, but I think you got out something out of this. These are dangerous times. Havenville has never been a city of warriors, but we might need the better defenses at hoping another sympathetic flying city comes along to help us. We will be fine as long as we have a defense tower or two operational. Do us a favor and talk to Mana at Castra Regnum. He'll be able to help you out. We should visit the academy. Havenville isn't quite as known for the scholars as Awenspire. Okay. Blueprints. Oh, so you can get more buildings. But they cost gold. Yeah, they're not the same, Saihun. They're not the same. Good bird talk, yeah. Okay. And at the market? The market you can trade. Okay. Very nice. Now? Nee, we need to... Achso, now we can visit street lamps. Okay. Now, it's a really nice game, guys. So I think you got a good first impression of it. Oh my god. There are pirates coming. What can we do? I don't know, guys. There are pirates. There? Okay, let's see what's happening. They're shooting us. Uh-oh. What can we do? Now it's going away. Okay. Okay, he's going away. Okay, I guess for that you need then towers. To protect yourself in the future. Yeah. But I think you got a good idea about the game as a first impression. I think it's really well done. It seems to be super lovely. I like also the music. The landscape is really nice. You have to some kind of story going on when you visit the towns. You can talk to people. You have quests. You gather materials. And it's really, really unique. It has its own charm. And then you have to also, you know, build your flying aircraft city. And also balance it and protect it. And all at once. That's really, really unique. Yeah, if you like the game, guys, put it on your wishlist. And check it out in the future. I think it's really, really promising. Super lovely. As my first impression is really, really good. And looking forward to see more of it. It's really nice. And really, really cool.